Welcome, Minneapolis Lion high school fans, to McCain Field here in Minneapolis at the Otter County Fairgrounds. April 7th, 2015. If you haven't got out to vote yet, there's still time. 4 o'clock today, as both the Lady Lions and the guys are taking on the Beloit Trojans here in NCAA League action this afternoon. Coming into today in this Lady Lions match against the Lady Trojans of Beloit, Minneapolis is 0-4 overall and 0-4 in the league. Beloit is 2-2, and these are their first league contests. They're going for their first wins in league play and NCAA play today. Beloit beat Concordia and lost to Clay Center in their four games that they played. Minneapolis lost to Republic County, and I can't remember now who they played in the first game, Sacred Heart. Quite lopsided scores in both of them, in all four games, quite honestly. Pitching is still developing for the Lady Lions, to be truthful. They've all juniors in their first three pitching staff, but they need to develop a little bit better than they have. We were so spoiled by Emily Corman last year. Starting for the Lady Lions of pitcher tonight is Kylie Roth. Number 11 at bat is Josie Wilson for the Trojans, and they get a hit into the gap. It's going to roll to the fence. Wilson's probably going to get an inside the park homer here. And she does. Hit the gap right where there was nobody. I guess that's what you do anyway, huh? So one up, one run on inside the park homer. For Wilson. A hit, an RBI, and a run. Up is number 10, Maeve Spangler. Is the catcher for the Trojans. Last time these two teams met was in the finals, their regional softball last year, with the Lady Lions taking home the trophy. And we have a walk. Up is number 24, Abby Beal, I believe is what I wrote down. Second base. High and outside. Trojans have one runner on at first. The pitch. And just over the outstretched arm to second baseman Forte. Second hit surrendered of the game by Roth. Steal by Spangler to get the third. Beal moves to the second. Up is Shaylen Crone for the Trojans. 2-0 is the count here. The 2-0 pitch, right back to Walker at third, who is able to pick off the lead runner, Spangler, at third. So we have a hit by Crone. third hit of the game, surrendered by Roth. Two runners on at second and first. The pitch is outside. Up is Obermiller, the pitcher. She fouls it back to the right. One out here, scores 1-0 Beloit. Count is 2-1 to Obermiller. The 2-1 pitch from Roth. Swung on and hit. Picked up by North. By Forte. Tags the runner at second. 24 scores from third. And Obermiller moves on to second base. 2-0, two outs here in the bottom of the first, top of the first. Up to bat is Morazis for Beloit. Outside is the pitch. The 1-0 pitch, inside and low. Two and oh the count. The pitch, high and outside. Lose the count to 3-0. The 3-0 pitch. Thought it might have caught the corner, but no. Morazis gets a walk. Moves on to first base. Second walk of the inning. 25 gets a bat on the ball. That's going to score 6 over Miller. Actually, that was Schamberg with the hit. 3-0 is the score. 4 hits surrendered in this inning. Number one gets a hit on the ball and is put out by Jade Willott on a nice catch the inside of the outfield. After one half inning of play, the Lady Trojans move out to a 3-0 lead. And they have gone through 7 of their hitters in the rotation here in this opening half of the inning. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors, Dale Leach, Regal Communications, Channel 20, and SalinaPost.com.
Ottawa County Bank in Minneapolis offers hometown banking with commitment, experience, and quality service. Proud sponsors of area school activities.
Tonight's game brought to you by City Pharmacy in Minneapolis. Now delivering to our neighboring communities. Call us to find out when we can come to you. City Pharmacy for your family. Go Lions!
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion Backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis proudly supporting the Lions.
Stop into Jean's IGA and experience shopping with a promise of neighborly service from people you know and trust. Jean's IGA, your hometown grocery store, supporting your hometown Lions.
Okay, welcome back to the bottom of the first. Jade Rilott, leadoff hitter for the Lions, up to bat. Plays shortstop. bunts. Goes foul. Jade, we got on base a lot last year with the short hit. So here comes the 0-1 pitch. Wow. Over Miller just stuck her mitt right out there and snagged that one. Good hit. Thought it was going to get by the pitcher, but. Kylie Roth, the pitcher up the bat. 1-0 the count here. 1-0 pitch outside. The 2-0 pitch on its way. Again. High and outside. 3-0 the count. The 3-0 pitch. Walker. Up next for the Lions, Nicole Forte. Playing second base. High and Roth. Thought about going to first or second. Thought better of it after she started, and then the ball was overthrown. She probably could have made it. 1-0 the count. High. 2-0. The 2-0 pitch. That one more in the strike zone. 2-1 the count now. The 2-1 pitch. Tapped. By Forte down the right sideline. Foul ball. Evens the count at 2-2. The 2-2 pitch by Overmiller. Caught her looking. Across the outside corner. For a strikeout for Overmiller. Is Shea Allison, third baseman. Take that back, catcher. She's number 5, playing catcher today. Strike one, low inside on the second pitch, 1-1. Two down here, inside. One runner on. The pitch. It's hit the pitcher. She gets out Allison at first. So the Lions strand one here. As did the Trojans in the first inning, but the Trojans get 3 runs. Make score 3-0 after one. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
For over 100 years, Robertson Monuments has created everlasting memories for families to share the lives of their loved ones with future generations. Supporting the Lions all the way, Robertson Monuments.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
County Bank in Minneapolis offers hometown banking with commitment, experience, and quality service. Proud sponsors of area school activities.
Tonight's game brought to you by City Pharmacy in Minneapolis. Now delivering to our neighboring communities. Call us to find out when we can come to you. City Pharmacy for your family. Go Go Lions!
Okay, welcome back to McCain Field. Otter County Fairgrounds, Minneapolis. We're ready for the top of the second action. Beloit versus Minneapolis here in NCAA play. Pitching for the Lions is Kylie Roth. First inning, she was no strikeouts, two walks, surrendered four hits. Up to bat for the Trojans here, starting the top of the second, is number 12, Haley Winkle. First baseman. Ross the pitch. Swung on. Hit. Tapped down by a lot, but throw to first is not in time. Number five, top of the order again, Josie Wilson, who got an inside the park homer to start things off. She hits it again. It gets out past into the gap on the other side this time. And it's probably going to score two runs. And two inside the park homers for Josie Wilson. Winkle's going to score, as does Wilson. Up to bat, number 10, Mae Spangler. Inside, 1-1 the count. Pitch. That's foul down the left field line. Score is 5-1, Beloit. 5-0, Beloit, excuse me. Pitch inside. Pitch swung on and fouled down the left field line. Makes the count 2-2. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Inside, ball three. Full count, 3-2. Pitch swung on and hit just over Lott's outstretched arm, tracked down by the left fielder. Mae Spangler with the hit. Up the bat is Abby Beal. She bunts to the left, foul. Beal had a hit and a run in the first inning. The pitch swung on and hit over Lott's head. Tracked down by third baseman Kylie Lott. Runners hold at third and second. Shaylin Crone up to bat for the Trojans. Swung on and hits pop up. Walker gets under it, makes the catch. one down. The pitch inside. Up is Erica Obermiller, the pitcher. Ross pitch, high and outside. 2-0 the count. The 2-0 pitch, swung on, hit. Gets by short. Two-run score, 10 and 24. Beal's second run of the game, first one for Spangler. Obermiller with the hit. Morazas up to bat for another tag of the ball into the outfield, cracked down by Faith Cornett. And the fielding error is going to move two runners, third and second. Strike called against Schamburg. She gets the ball tagged and is out at first, fielded by Forte. Three runs in the first inning for the Trojans, four in this inning so far. Two outs. The score 7-0. Up to bat is Kennedy Brown, who had a fly out in the first inning. That's error on the throw is going to score number six, Obermiller. Her second of the game. Morazas on to third. Brown still up the bat, makes the score 8-0. Pitch swung on and hit. Walker fields it and thrown out at first. Is Brown. Her second ground out of the game. Ends the inning. The Trojans strand one. After one half a play, it's 8 for the Trojans, 0. After one and one half innings plays, 8 for the Trojans, 1-0 for the Lions. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion Backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis, proudly supporting the Lions.
Stop into Jeans IGA and experience shopping with a promise of neighborly service from people you know and trust. Jeans IGA, your hometown grocery store supporting your hometown Lions.
For over 100 years, Robertson Monuments has created everlasting memories for families to share the lives of their loved ones with future generations. Supporting the Lions all the way, Robertson Monuments.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Okay, welcome back to the bottom of the second. 10 hits by the Trojans in two innings. Up is Walker, third baseman for the Lady Lions. Overmiller's pitch inside. Ball two. 2-0 pitch. Swung on, hit, and that's goes in the gap. Walker's on first. Track by down by the center fielder, Morales. So the first hit of the game, first hit of the game for the Lions by Walker. The pitch high and outside. For Faith Cornick, up the bat, center fielder. 1-0 pitch, swung on, hit into the gap between third and short. Faith is to first. Walker's on down to second. First baseman. Up to bat. Kylie Vaught. Strike one. Low and inside, and Walker tries to steal third and is put out. Cornick moves on to second. Pitch. Pop up back to the screen. Pitcher Spangler could not get underneath it. 2-2 the count for Kylie Lott. Over Miller's 2-2 pitch. Inside. 3-2, full count now. Over Miller's 3-2 pitch. Foul down the left side by Lott. To the count. Swung on a miss, strike her out. Second strikeout of the game for Overmiller. Up is Smith. Foul ball. Smith plays left field. Amron. Is her name. And it's tipped. First baseman, or the pitcher's able to retrieve the ball in time and throw her out at first. So after two innings of play, it's the Lady Trojans 8, Minneapolis 0. The Lions have stranded one runner each inning, as have the Trojans. Trojans have been very effective in hitting our pitching. Hasn't been much real wild pitching on Nasus, on Ross Park, but the Trojans have been figuring out how to hit that ball well. We'll be back for the top of the third coming up.
Ottawa County Bank in Minneapolis offers hometown banking with commitment, experience, and quality service. Proud sponsors of area school activities.
Tonight's game brought to you by City Pharmacy in Minneapolis, now delivering to our neighboring communities. Call us to find out when we can come to you. City Pharmacy for your family. Go Lions!
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion Backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis, proudly supporting the Lions.
Welcome back to McCain Field. Top of the third action. The Lions trailing the Beloit Trojans 8-0. Up is number 12, Haley Winkle. got a hit and scored a run first time up. Cross pitch. Caught. Got the hit by Forte. Wilson, who has had two inside the park homers, and she hits another one to the outfield. This one's not going to be inside the park homer, tracked down by Smith. She will get a multi-base hit, her third of the game. A double. Up, Mae Spangler, number 10. Catcher. Pitch. In each of those hits by Wilson, I mean, I don't believe she's let a pitch get by her. She swung on the first strike and done damage. Lot. Throw to first, doesn't make it. Throwing error. Scores Wilson her third run of the game. Hit on an error by Spangler. Inside, it's going to move Spangler on to second. Up the bat is Abby Beal, 24, the second baseman. The pitch, inside and low. To know the count. The 2-0 pitch, high and outside. 3-0 the count. The 3-0 pitch. Strike one. Three-one pitch. It's hit and tracked down by Lott. Out at first. Moves Spangler to second. Beals ground out. Two down here. And tags that ball. It's over the infield. Tracked down by Smith. Scores. Spangler. Low. Crone moves on to second. Overmiller, the pitcher's up to bat. Pitch is low. Crone steals third. Three-oh pitch. Strike one on the corner, inside corner. Three and one the count. There's a walk. Third walk of the game for Roth. Over Miller on base with the walk. Runners at the corners. Over Miller steals to second. Ross is up to bat. She's got one hit. Two RBIs. Get a third one here. Another second hit. Up is 25, Schamberg. And the steal is going. second. One and oh the count with two outs. Schamburg up the bat. She's had one hit. And Obermiller is going to score on a steal. Steals home, her third run of the game. Four runs this inning, makes the score 12-0. Two outs, 3-0 the count. Foul ball for Schamburg. 3-1 the count here. High. So the fourth walk was written by Roth. Schamburg on base with a walk. Kennedy Brown up the bat. Number one, she's had two flyouts so far. Runners at the corners for the Trojans. Inside, Schamburg moves to second on a steal. Outside, ball two. And we're going to have time out to visit with the pitching staff. I don't see any directions being given, pointing fingers, moving players around. Like there's going to be a change in pitching. Lineup remains the same. It's 2-0 here. Two outs. Top of the third. Kennedy Brown up to bat for the Trojans. The pitch inside, ball three. The 3-0 pitch, high. And a walker. Fifth walk of the game for Roth. Brown on base with the walk. Her first time on base today. Haley Winkle, the ninth batter in the order for the Trojan. High and outside. Out of every base here. The pitch. High and inside. It's tagged foul down the left side. So 1-1 the count, the pitch, low. The pitch, swung on, hit, and tracked down by Forte. Should be an out at first. It is in the inning. Ground out for Winkle. After 2.5 innings, it's the Beloit Trojans 8, Minneapolis 0. The Trojans scored 3 innings in the opening inning, 5 in the second, 4 this time. Led off by Josie Wilson, number 6, 3 multi-base hits on the first pitch of each of her at-bats. 2 inside the park homers and a double. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
Stop into Jean's IGA and experience shopping with a promise of neighborly service from people you know and trust. Jeans IGA, your hometown grocery store supporting your hometown Lions.
For over 100 years, Robertson Monuments has created everlasting memories for families to share the lives of their loved ones with future generations. Supporting the Lions all the way, Robertson Monuments.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Ottawa County Bank in Minneapolis offers hometown banking with commitment, experience, and quality service. Proud sponsors of area school activities.
Tonight's game brought to you by City Pharmacy in Minneapolis, now delivering to our neighboring communities. Call us to find out when we can come to you. City Pharmacy for your family. Go Lions!
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School.
Okay, Cameron Nace up to bat. Last batter in the order here for the Lions, first time through. Ball one. Outside, ball two. Two-oh pitch, swung on, hit, and tracked down by the shortstop. And the throwing error at first. Nace on first. Third hit of the game for the Lions. Third surrender by Overmiller. Up, Jade Relott. Fly out in the first inning. Second time through the order for the Lions. Pitch goes for the bunt, foul. Strike one. The pitch. Swing and a miss, strike two. 0-2 the count. The 0-2 pitch, swung on, foul down the third baseline. 2-0 the count, or 1-2 the count remains. The 0-2 pitch, caught her looking on the outside corner, struck her out. Third strike out of the game for Overmiller. Kylie Roth, pitcher, up the bat. Shows bunt. But it's a ball. 1-0 the count. Bunts that time, it's foul. One and one the count. A 1-1 pitch. Outside, swung on. 1-2 the count. The 1-2 pitch, low. 2-2. Time up, Roth walked. And was stranded on base. The 2-2 pitch. She gets that ball tracked down by the shortstop, out at second, and safe at first. Hit by Roth. Nace out at second on a base running out. Up is Nicole Forte. She lays some wood on the ball. She'll be out at first. So, after three complete innings, it's Beloit Minneapolis, 0. And the Lions have stranded a runner each time around. As we move on to the top of the fourth action, right back after this word from our sponsors.
Lion backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis proudly supporting the Lions.
Stop into Jean's IGA and experience shopping with a promise of neighborly service from people you know and trust. Jean's IGA, your hometown grocery store supporting your hometown Lions.
For over 100 years, Robertson Monuments has created everlasting memories for families to share the lives of their loved ones with future generations. Supporting the Lions all the way, Robertson Monuments.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Ottawa County Bank in Minneapolis offers hometown banking with commitment, experience, and quality service. Proud sponsors of area school activities.
All right, welcome back to McCain Field, Ottawa County Fairgrounds in Minneapolis. This NCAA contest between the Beloit Trojans and Minneapolis Lady Lions. 12-0 after three innings. Josie Wilson up the bat for the third time around. Fourth time, actually. She's had two inside the park homers. And another multi-base hit. She got a double on her third time up. And she's going to get a third in the base. In third home run here. Inside the park homer. Three RBIs, four hits, four runs. .13 And she has swung on the first pitch every time. Looks like for a second that the right fielder might be under that ball, but it came over her head. Ten takes a swing, pop up, and Lott and Smith, neither one can get to it. So Spangler with a hit. And at 24. Abby Beal with a hit. Just over the outstretched arms of Lott. Shaylin Crone up the bat. Walker retrieves the ball, force out at third for Spangler. Six tags the ball, and that's going foul. No, fair. It's going to score 24 and 20. Beal and Crone. Obermiller, the pitcher. Her second hit of the game. It's multi-base. It's a triple. Morosis up the bat. Swung on. Strikeout. Or missed. for the strike. 15-0 here. Field of error by Walker gets the hit for Morazes. Track to town, but couldn't make the catch. Runners at the bases, one out. Up the bat is Schamberg, who had a hit her last time up. Inside is the pitch. And Obermiller with the run. And two steals racked up there. Obermiller and Morazes. 16-4. Hits surrendered by the Lions so far. Foul ball down the left field line. The pitch outside. One out here. 2-3-1 the count. Pitch low, walks her. Sixth walk of the game for Roth. Schamberg on base with the walk. Up the bat will be Kennedy Brown. Into the count here. Low and outside, there's the walk for Schamberg. Now Brown's up the bat. Inside, Schamberg steals second. One though, one out here. Got the outside corner, strike two. Just strike one. 1-1 the count. 1-1 pitch, swung on, fouled. Two pitch coming up for Roth. High. 2-2. Two runners in scoring position at second and third. The 2-2 pitch. So on hit. Foul. Down the left field line. Two pitch, low and inside. And that's going to produce a run. For Morazes, I believe that was. Brown's hit. Force out the guy's hit by the earth. Tagged by catch by Lott, and she gets the throw home to Allison to throw out Schamberg on the base running out. first of the game. Had two flyouts and a walk previously. Hey, Winkle up the bat. She's had one hit, one flyout. We have a big error that's going to move a runner from second and on to third. Pitch inside low. Two outs, one and one the count here. 17-0 the score. Inside, ball two. Inside, ball three. Inside low. Pitch, swung on and tagged. Lott gets it, but stumbles. That's going to score Brown. Winkle with the hit on an RBI. Each player in the starting nine for the Trojans has scored now. Wilson up to bat for her fifth time. She's had four multi-base hits, three inside the park homers, and one double. First time she hasn't swung and hit the first pitch tonight. 1-1 the count. The 1-1 pitch, swung on and hit, and it's going to go to center field. Caught by Faith Cornick. Wilson's fly out. Five hits in that inning makes the score. Five runs in that inning, excuse me. Six runs in that inning. Makes the score 18-0 unless the Lions get a whole lot of offense going here. In the bottom of the fourth, we should have a run rule game. Trojans having their way, 18-0 after 3.5. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
Ottawa County Bank in Minneapolis offers hometown banking with commitment, experience, and quality service. Proud sponsors of area school activities.
Tonight's game brought to you by City Pharmacy in Minneapolis, now delivering to our neighboring communities. Call us to find out when we can come to you. City Pharmacy for your family. Go Lions!
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion Backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis proudly supporting the Lions.
Welcome back to McCain Field. Start at the bottom of the fourth. Shay Allison up for the Lady Lions. She had one ground out in her first time through. Low inside. Shortstop tracks down the ball, but not in time for the out, so Allison gets a hit. First, fourth hit of the game surrendered by Overmiller. Up Courtney Walker. She had a hit in the first game, first time around. Ball one. One-oh pitch, outside or inside. Ball two. Two pitch. Throw out attempt at first is no good. 3-0 the count. Walker swings and misses. 3-1 the count here. pitch, fouled, back into the fence. Three and two the count. Fouled back into the fence again. Two pitch coming up, full count. Tags it, and shortstop picks it up. Allison's out at first, Walker on to second. It's Walker's second hit of the game. Fifth hit surrendered by Obermiller. Faith Hornuck up for the Lady Lions. She got a hit her first time up. One out here. Walker at first. 0-1 the count. The pitch popped up. First baseman gets under it for the out. Kylie Lott up to bat. First baseman. She had a strikeout her first time around. Two outs here, one ball here in the first in this occurrence. Two balls. The 2-0 pitch. Swung on and hit, tracked down by the second baseman, and she's out at first, and that's going to end the game, if I know the rules correctly. Apparently don't know the rules correctly. Now that is going to end the game. After four innings play, the run rule is going to take effect. The final score is 18-0 in favor of the Trojans. They go to 3-2. Minneapolis goes to 0-5. 0-5 in the league. And Beloit is 1-0 in the league. Overall, the pitching wasn't bad as far as wildness is concerned, but a lot of hits. At 17 hits surrendered by Roth. Every batter in the lineup for Beloit was able to get on base with a hit. Six, no strikeouts for Roth, six walks surrendered, 17 hits, team errors, three. Obermiller, the winning pitcher, three strikeouts, one walk, surrendered five hits. Star of the game for the Lady Trojans, Josie Wilson, the shortstop, number five. Four multi-base hits in five times around. Three of those are inside the park homers. The other one was a double. And she flied out her fifth time around. So that's going to end the day for us. They'll have one more game to play here tonight. You can come down to watch it live at McCain Field at the Ottawa County Fairgrounds in Minneapolis. Our next broadcast will be next Tuesday. Be the baseball action this time around. I can't remember who it is, if it's Little River or who, but baseball action coming up next Tuesday with the guys. Well, I'll be right back next week. Dale Leach going to sign off. Regal Communications, Channel 20. SalinaPost.com. Thanks, as always, for listening to your source for MHS Sports.